Well, that's a wrap. The final presidential debate is in the books, so now it's time to fact check. I'm Ariane Detil with Verify. Let's get right into it. The debate started with a series of claims about the coronavirus. First up, here's Vice President Biden.
The expectation is we'll have another 200,000 Americans dead between now and the end of the year.
This claim is false. It's based on outdated estimates from the University of Washington's Institute for Health Metrics. In early September, they projected approximately 410,000 U.S. coronavirus deaths by January 1st of 2021. As of the night of the debate, October 22nd, 2020, their estimate is just under 317,000 U.S. coronavirus deaths by January 1st, 2021. And as of today, there have been 223,000 U.S. coronavirus deaths. Now here's President Trump.
If you notice, the mortality rate is down 85%.
This claim is false. Mortality rate tracks the percentage of patients who die from a disease after being diagnosed. Johns Hopkins data estimates that the current observed mortality rate in the U.S. is 2.7%. When Verify first reported on the COVID-19 mortality rate back in January, the mortality rate was about 2%. So that is actually an increase. The 85% number that the president mentioned, well, that can be found by comparing the number of weekly deaths during the peak back in April to the most recent recorded week. On the week of April 18th, 17,077 people died, according to CDC data. On the week of October 10th, 2,540 people died. That is a drop of about 85%. Now let's talk about immigration. Here's Trump on the cages used to hold children at the border.
And they said, look at these cages. President Trump built them. And then it was determined they were built in 2014. That was him.
This claim is true. Our source, a 2019 interview that former ICE director Thomas Homan did with the Center for Immigration Studies. According to the transcript, he said, I've been to that facility where they talk about cages. That facility was built under President Obama, under Secretary Jay Johnson. I was there because I was there when it was built. He continued, saying the facility was built and funded in fiscal year 2015. An article from the Associated Press confirms the facility's projected opening date in mid-July 2014, with plans for four fence-enclosed pods inside a corrugated steel warehouse that could accommodate about 1,000 children. Okay, we're gonna pivot to Biden on health insurance.
Not one single person with private insurance would lose their insurance under my plan, nor did they under Obamacare. They did not lose their insurance unless they chose they wanted to go to something else.
This claim is false. Our source, Health Affairs, a peer-reviewed journal on health policy and affairs. They found that in 2013, some non-group health insurance plans were canceled because they weren't compliant with the Affordable Care Act or Obamacare standards. The journal said many of those people were eligible for coverage assistance, but also said there was potential for some of those people to pay significantly more. Let's move on to the environment, starting with Trump on carbon emissions.
And we have the best carbon emission numbers that we've had in 35 years.
It's actually 25 years, not 35. Our sources, the World Bank and the EPA. According to the World Bank, American carbon emissions in 2016 were at their lowest point in 25 years. It had no data listed for 2017 through 2019. But just for kicks, we also looked at US greenhouse gas emissions, and they were the lowest in 25 years back in 2017, according to the EPA. But the next year in 2018, greenhouse gas emissions went up. Now a claim from Biden.
He won't give federal subsidies to solar and wind.
Yeah.
Why are we giving it to oil industry?
This claim is false. There are currently tax credits available to both the wind and solar industry, like the production tax credit and investment tax credit for wind. It offers tax credit per kilowatt hour for utility scale wind. And it was actually extended under the Trump administration in December of 2017. The fossil fuel industry, well, they also receive subsidies, and those are mostly in tax credits. Okay, we gave you three Trump claims and three Biden claims, and I promise you there are plenty more that we just couldn't fit in here. So text FACTS to 703-873-6603. You can see all of them and more. Until next time.